Jared Square plus U Square from these two equations.
Okay.
Jared Square plus U Square equal to R Square. So in place of this, this is R in the denominator, and U is R sine theta. So R sine theta upon R, R are cancelled out, this is sine theta. In place of dr du, we have substituted sine theta. And this del V upon del R is here, del V upon del R same. Similarly, del V del theta, this d theta upon du we have to find out. Then theta is from this one, you can get what is tan theta. This is tan theta, this upon this, tan theta equal to u upon j. Tan theta is right here. Tan theta is equal to u upon j. Theta equal to tan inverse u upon j. What is value of this? Let me differentiate this. We have to find out here del theta, d theta du, this is d theta du, is equal to how much? This will be again z square divided by u square plus z square. Now again differentiation of what? U upon z. We are differing with respect to u. It will be 1 upon z only. Z, 1 z cancelled out. This will be z upon, let me write here, d theta du equal to z upon u square plus z square. But u square plus z square equal to r square. This u square plus z square equal to r square from this. This one. This, and z equal to how much? Z equal to r cos theta. This is r cos theta upon r square. This is cos theta upon r here. This is cos theta upon r. We have substituted. Okay, so from this equation, del V upon del U, I have substituted these values. Okay, so this, I've just shown here that how we have substituted these values. Now let me come to the main point. Okay, so all these things are obtained here. So del V, del U, we have got this value. Now this is in terms of R and theta. Now if I substitute 1 upon U into del V, del U, if I multiply this by 1 upon u here, what will be this? Now this will be 1 upon u is here, r sine theta. So divide this whole by r sine theta, this whole value. It will be r, this sine theta upon r sine theta, that means sine theta cancel out 1 upon r. This will be 1 upon r into del v del r. Okay. Plus cos theta divided by r into r sine theta. Cos theta upon sin theta is cot theta. This is cot theta. On r into r is r square. Because value of u is r sin theta. If I divide cos theta upon r by r sin theta, so r into r will be r square here. And cos theta upon sin theta is cot theta. This is into del v del theta. Okay, so this is in terms of theta here. So 1 upon u del v del theta, this is that we take. The fourth equation, second, this is third one, I've taken third equation here. What do we see here? This del square V upon del U square, del square V upon del Z square, this value is equal to this. Okay. Now, 1 upon U del V upon del U, this we have obtained here in third one. Okay, and 1 upon U square, I'll substitute as 1 upon R square sine square theta, that is not a matter of discussion, this. U is equal to r sine theta. In place of this 1 upon u square initially in the first equation, this one. The final the value of this will be obtained. Now let me substitute all these three equations. This third one, first one, in first one from second and third. If I substitute the values, what do we get? Now from, let me write here, from first, second and third, we get from first, second and third, what do we get? Del square V, which we have to calculate here. Del square, this is del square V, is equal to this equation. In thus, in place of these two, we have calculated these two values. From second, let me substitute this. This will be del square V upon del R square, this whole value plus 1 upon R, del V del R, okay, plus 1 upon R square into del square U upon del theta square. Okay, now plus this is the value of del square V upon del U square plus del square V upon del Z square. which is this value we have substituted in place of this, these two. At one point u del v del u, which is this one. This also I have to add here. Let me write it here. This is one point r del v del r. One point r, this one, plus cot theta upon r square. This is del v del theta. Okay, plus this one point u, this last step. One point u is u also converted into r and theta, so this will be r square sine square theta. R square sine square theta, okay, into del square u upon del phi square. Issue. Del phi square. This is del phi square. So in terms of phi, theta and r, but let me, similar, there are like terms, this is one like term. Okay, so these two are added and others are different. If one point r square, this is different. Okay. Now let me summarize this. The final value of this equation in terms of r, theta and phi will be, therefore, let me write here, del square v, which is transformed into, okay, or this is nothing but del square u, del square v upon del u, sorry, this is x square, but del square v upon del y square, del square v upon del z square, where x, y, z are like this, is equal to, finally, we have obtained, in terms of r and theta and phi, is del square v upon del r square, this is first one, plus 1 upon r del v del r, 1 upon r del v del r is twice upon r del v del r, okay, plus 1 upon r square, this one, del square u, upon del theta square, which is plus cot theta upon r square. This is del v del theta. It could be written before this, after this, and plus 1 upon r square cosec square theta could be written here in the numerator, or in the denominator that here sine square theta. This is value of u square here. Okay, into del square u upon del phi square, phi, theta and r. This equation, this whole value is transformed into Cartesian, into polar coordinates r, theta and phi, phi, r, theta and phi. The operator, this stands for this. This whole value is converted into these coordinates. Okay, this is final answer we have obtained. This is the answer of polar coordinates r, theta and phi. The value finally is converted, transformed into this value. Now let me take next question. So this is converted into polar coordinates. The final answer. Okay. Now let me take the fifth question. What does it say? Question number fifth. Let me take. Okay, question number 5 is now, what does it say? This one. Question number 5 says, if, okay, x raised power y, plus y raised power x, equal to constant c, then find, okay, this is the value of d by dx, find the value of, or to find here, let's find the value of d by dx. This is total differential coefficient. Okay, so we have to find our value of d by dx here. Here it is, this one. Okay, so d by dx. Now, let me find out d by dx. What is the value of d by dx here? That, let me find out. So, what is, this is in terms of x here. So if I consider it as a function, let me take f x y, this is function here, equal to x y, this y raised power x, minus c can also be written here, for this is equal to 0, okay, which is, or this can be taken as function. Well, by differential C, it will be constant. If I find out, so we know that d by dx is equal to, okay, if it is an implicit function, which I just expressed, because here we know that d by dx is 0. D by dx from this equation, okay, is equal to 0 here. But d by dx, this function, let me find out d by dx is what. Okay, so d by dx, we know that this is minus del f on del x in terms of partial differentiation. This I talked about in implicit functions, divided by del f del y. Okay, so this one, what was this? This was d by dx. Okay, or let me take this is del f here. Here we know that del f del x is equal to 0. Because this value, if I take, only this value. But we know that del f del x, if I find out this differentiation is equal to constant 0. But, df equal to 0 on this equation we have. If I differentiate this, this means we know that what is df upon dx is equal to del f into dx upon dx, first equation. Plus this is del f del y into d by dx. Now this is 0 here. This I have already explained implicit function, regarding implicit function. This is 0 here, del f del x. But this is 1 dx dx, del f del x only. And this is del f del y into d by dx. This implies that d by dx is equal to, in case of implicit function, I've explained this already. So minus del f upon del x, what is this? Del x divided by del f del y. This one. From the d by dx is equal to this minus del f upon del x divided by del f del y. So this we have to find out from this equation. Okay, so now let me find out this value. So this I've just proved again. Now let me find out what is the value of this equation. Why is this making marks? Okay, so this from this equation here, let me find out what is del f del x. Differentiating the first equation, let this equal to this. So differentiating first with respect to x, partially, this is nothing but del f del x. Let me write here. Here y is constant. We have taken y as constant. This will be equal to del f del x is what from this equation. We have taken y as constant, that means x is for y. So that will be what value? This will be now x y into x raised power y minus 1. This constant x raised power 2. What is that? 2 into x raised power 2 minus 1. Similar value because here y we have taken as constant. Now plus sign, now this y is constant. We know that e raised power x is what differentiation of that will be. E raised power x, that means y raised power x into log of a means here y, log of y to the base e. This is total value of this. So here y raised power x, e raised power x, we know differentiation of a raised power x dx of this. We know that similarly, we have to differentiate this equal to a raised power x into log of a. By this formula, we have applied here, the same formula we have applied. So this is what we have obtained here. Okay, so this is del of del f del x here. Let me write it as second equation. This was the first one. This is this second equation. Now, differentiating first with respect to y, differentiating first with respect to y, that means del f del y, here x is constant. Okay, this is equal to how much? Again, now x is constant here, so the differentiation of this will be in the same fashion as x raised power y into log of x to the base e plus sign. Now y we are differing with respect to y as x raised power, now x is constant. It will be x into y raised power x minus 1 only. This is, let me take third equation. from second and third, what would we get? Therefore, d by dx is equal to minus del x divided by del f del y, which is equal to this is del f del y, that means minus, I have to add this whole equation, this is y x raised to the power y minus 1 plus y raised to the power x into log of e by divided by this whole value, this is shown, this is y raised to the power, sorry, x raised to the power y, sorry, this one, x raised to the power y into log of dx plus x into y raised to the power x minus 1. Okay, this could be further simplified. Now, the negative sign will be there. If I take, let me take y raised to the power, sorry, nothing is common. Only y can be taken common. No. So this is only the answer. No further simplification. So this is the answer here. We have to find out. Okay, this is d by dx. So d by dx is calculated from this fifth equation we have done. Okay. Let me take the next equation. Next question. Question number 6 now. What the question number 6 is? We take the 6th question. Okay, so question number 6 is this one. If u is equal to x square minus y square sine y z, where y is equal to this, z equal to log dx, and find du dx. Okay. That we have to find out. This is 6th question here. Question 6 says, if u is equal to x square minus y square, okay, this is plus sine y into z, okay, where y is equal to e raised to power x, and z is equal to log of x to the base e. Okay. This is log of x to the base e. Z is equal to, no problem. Then find d by dx again. Again the same type of question. Here du dx. This is not d by dx but du dx. Sorry. This is du. Yes, we have to find out. Okay, so what is the question here? For that, let me find out the formula for this du dx. We know that total differential coefficient that is given to us as du dx is equal to del u del x into dx dx. This we know. But this is del u del y into d by dx. Plus del u del z into dz dx. So this is one. We can further write it as del u del x plus del u del y into dy dx del u del z into dz dx. Okay, this is what we have obtained here. Now from this we will find out dz dx, oh sorry, this one, z equal to dz dx, we can calculate from this. Okay, d by dx we can calculate from this. And this is for partial differentiation. Okay, so let me find out these values. Then du dx is calculated. Then we will substitute the value for du dx. So in this case we require del u del x, del u del y, del u del z first. So differentiate in this equation. But we take this as the first equation. This is the first equation, not solution. Differentiating first. Okay, partially with respect to x first. That means del u del x. Here what we have taken? Y is equal to constant. Z equal to constant. These two we have taken as constant. This del u del x will be what? Only twice x. First equation. Because we are defining with respect to x. So x square is twice x here. Now this is 0. Cosine y z y square is also 0. Okay, so only this is the tell you. First you question. Now, then tell you thereby. Here now x equal to constant. So we are differentiating with respect to now y partially. So other constant, other variables independent will be constant. So other variables constants. Let me write clearly. This is constant here. Okay, so we are now differentiating the first with respect to y, del u del y. Okay, so this is called, let me write here. So from this one, this is minus 2 by y square, x square is 0, but we are differentiating now with respect to y, taking x and z constant. But here y is also there. It will be, because z is constant, y z will be again differentiated, but before that it will be sine by z is cos by z. Because now y z, z is constant here, multiply by z, region y will be 1, y z is to be again differentiated, y is 1, z will be constant. This is the value of del u del y from this equation, from first one. So this is total value of this. Z into cos by z. Why cos by z? Because sin by z is cos by z differentiation. But by z will again be differentiated with respect to y. Y is 1 and z is constant, multiplied by is constant. And if we write here, del u del z is equal to how much? Here, x and y are constant. Let me write here, x constant and y is constant. Okay, this partially we are differentiating. This can be written here. So what is value of del u del z? From the same, these are 2, 0, but this only is differentiated. That means here z is there, so it will be cos by z. Now we are referring to the respect z here. Okay, so this will be into y. That means y into cos of y z. Now we are referring to the respect to z here. So this is sine y z or z by, this will be cos by z into by z will be again differentiated. Y is constant in this case, z is differentiated, z is 1. So this is y into cos by z. Okay, this is value of del u del z. Now from these two equations, we have to find out d by dx, dz dx from these two given equations. Now differentiating first one, so d by dx and, or let me write here, differentiating y equal to ex with respect to x. Okay, here y is a function of x that's given to us. It will be d by dx. Okay, this is capital total differential or ordinary differentiation. This will be ex only. Because here y is a function of x, it will be ex only differentiation. So d by dx is this. And if we differentiate this one, and differentiating, okay, z equal to log of ex. Now here z is a function of x here. So z with respect to x. Okay, so that will be dz dx. Here z is a function of x. It will be log dx means 1 upon x here. Only differentiation. Okay, so these two values are of this. If I substitute all these values, this one is del u del x. Here, let me write here all the values. Therefore, du dx equal to du dx finally is it del u del x. Del u del x is 2x. Okay, this is with minus sign here. This is del u del y. We multiply this del u del y by d by dx. D by dx is e raised power x. So this will be, let me write here. This is with plus sign, let me write here. Minus 2 by plus z into cos y z into e raised power x. Plus sign. Del u del z, what is del u del z? Del u del z is y cos y z. This is y into cos y z. Okay, into 1 upon x here. Good. Then dz dx. Dz dx is 1 upon x. This is 1 upon x. The final answer is this. This is value of du dx. Let me write it clearly. So finally, the value of du dx is obtained. So du dx is equal to total differential coefficient in terms of partial differentiation as total differentiation, okay, or ordinary differentiation. So this value will be, if I take x LCM, then can be done from this, multiply this, doing this, okay, so or this can be written in the same way, there no problem, because this is y upon x here, okay, and if I take LCM x, then x square will be here, this will be twice x square either, plus this is x into this whole value, this means, let me write z into or xz or z into x into cos of yz minus twice xy into e raised power x, this x into this, these two, plus this is y into cos yz divided by whole x. Okay, this may be the answer, or simply y upon x can be written here, and these are same value. So this is the answer, or this is the answer. Okay, so both can be the answers. Either of them are the answer, or okay, whichever is simplified. Either this is simplified one, or this is simplified one. No need of taking LCM x as, okay. So this is y upon x multiply this only. That can be the answer. So this is the answer here. Okay, so this is your question number 6. This question number 6 we have done here. Now 7th question, let me take. What did it say? Okay. Now question number 7. Question number 7th is again of the partial differentiation or total differential coefficient that we check. Now question number 7th here is, what did it say? It says if xyz are connected by the equation this and this, okay, are connected, let me write the whole thing, are connected by the equations, another equations y, x, y, z, okay, is equal to 0, no problem, and psi is x, y, and z here, okay, equal to 0. And what does it say? Then find d by dx. Okay. Then to find d by dx. Then find d by dx. Okay, this is we have to find out. Here d by dx is to be calculated. Now if I, now this is because a function, which is implicit function in this case, because is phi is a function of x, y, and z, three variables. If I express this, okay, in terms of x, y, and z, then what do we get? This will be, okay, because x, y, z and psi x, y, z. If I express these three equations in terms of x, y, and z, we see here that d by dx, sorry, is del phi upon del x equal to 0. Here del psi upon del x equal to 0. Okay, so that is known to us, because if I find out with respect to x here, this whole equal to 0, right inside is 0. So we know that, let me write here, this is d phi dx, which is 0, we will do. And we know that this is equal to how much in terms of x, y, z. It will be del phi upon del x into dx upon dx. This we always write, okay, as a total differential coefficient. And this is del phi upon del y into, this is d by dx plus del phi del z into dz dx. This is first equation, but this is 0 here, because del phi del x is 0, because equal to 0 here. The source solution is going to be 0. This is equal to 0 here, let me write this first equation. Similarly, this is value of d by dx, or we can write like this equal to 0. Why? Because d phi dx, we calculate this equal to 0. the resultant is 0. So, but the solution of this is like this. D phi dx is like this. Similarly, d psi dx is 0. So if I write d psi, this is first equation. If I write d psi dx, that will be del psi 1, and this is 1 here. Del psi del x, and this is dx dx. This is x here. Okay, plus this is del psi del y. This is d y dx. Del psi del z into dz dx. Okay, this is your second. This is equal to 0. And this is your second equation. Okay, this we have written. This is 1. So let me further write them. First is del phi del x plus del phi del y d by dx. Okay, plus del phi del z into dz dx. This is, let me write the first equation. Or this is equal to 0. Let me write it here, 0. This is the first equation. Second, 0 equal to this value. Okay, this is 1. Because this I have to write here only single this. That's why I have written this again. Del psi del psi upon del x plus del psi upon del y into dy dx plus del psi del z into dz dx. This is second equation. Now, from just these two equations, I have to find out what is d by dx. It says find out d by dx. If I have to find out d by dx, then this is to be eliminated, dz, because the value of d by dx is mostly in terms of x and y. Okay, so these two are to be retained. From these two, we can find out the value. So this is to be eliminated. So just to eliminate this, what we have to multiply? If I multiply this as del psi del z, the first equation, and this one as del phi del z. Okay, so multiplying first, let me write here. Multiplying first by del psi del z, and sorry, multiplying first by this and del phi del z, and second by del phi del z. Okay, this is del phi del z, is del psi del z. Del psi del z